Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, ala halal family. Welcome to the channel, you beautiful people. I hope you guys are having yourself a wonderful day. In today's video, guys, we'll be reacting to why 7-Eleven failed in Indonesia. I saw this in the suggested video, so I thought it was pretty interesting. I picked it and wanted to share it with you guys. So the video is by CNBC, and the link is in the description in case you guys wanted to check it out. And inshallah, we'll get started with the video in just a couple seconds. And at the end of the video, I'll share with you guys my observation and reactions. If you guys want to see it, then please stay until the end of the video. And with that said, guys, now let's get started.
There are more than 60,000 7-Elevens across the planet. But there is one country where the convenience store chain flopped. Indonesia. In 2017, the chain of mini markets closed all of its stores there. Here's why 7-Eleven failed in Indonesia. Let's go back to 2009, when 7-Eleven got its start in the country. 7-Eleven's Indonesian rollout was run by a local operator, PT Modern International. Contrary to its American counterpart that capitalized on to-go items and late-night munchies, 7-Eleven in Indonesia became a trendy hangout spot for locals. It offered traditional 7-Eleven items like Slurpees and snacks, but also fresh local food and alcohol.
7-Eleven was very popular with university students, really the 18 to 25 age range. It was a place for them to hang out at all hours of the day, all hours of the night. Before the alcohol ban that was imposed in 2015, this was a very popular spot to hang out, have a beer after class or after work, have free Wi-Fi, have a bite to eat.
As the business took off, Modern soon started to expand within the capital, Jakarta. It opened its 21st store by 2010, and it hit 100 locations in 2012. In 2014, the company hit peak sales of around 78 million with 190 stores. The future of 7-Eleven in Indonesia seemed promising. The stores remained crowded, but there was one problem. People weren't spending money.
Where actually there are some comments that there, yes, there's a huge crowd in 7-Eleven, but they might just buy one drink, one bread, and sit for 3 hours.
The company also attributed its lack of sales to intense competition from existing and new competitors. By 2016, the number of retail outlets in Indonesia had grown from 12,000 to 40,000 in just under a decade, with mini markets being the sector's fastest growing segment. Two of 7-Eleven's biggest competitors were Indonesian convenience stores Indomaret and Alfamart. Both chains have a long history in the country and are top players in Indonesia's convenience store market. 7-Eleven had 190 stores in the country, but its competitor store count absolutely squashed that. As of 2017, there were more than 10,000 Alfamarts and roughly 15,000 Indomarets in Indonesia, giving Alfamart a 38% share of the market and Indomaret 47%. That was the year 7-Eleven closed all of its shops, but before that, it held just 0.7% of the market. Regulatory issues also posed a major problem for 7-Eleven. In 2015, Indonesia banned the sale of alcoholic beverages in convenience stores and mini-marts. After the alcohol ban took effect, 7-Eleven's net sales dropped by nearly 24% over the next year. Unlike 7-Eleven, its rivals Indomaret and Alfamart actually reported revenue gains that year. Alfamart and Indomaret were able to withstand the ban because they offered a wider range of products and services. 7-Eleven's geographic reach posed another big problem. The convenience store chain never managed to expand beyond Jakarta and its surrounding cities, but its rivals did.
They are located in Jakarta, whereas other mini markets can expand outside Jakarta. One is, I think, the regulations for foreign ownerships of or foreign franchise of convenience stores. Because Indomaret and Alfamart, Alfamart and Indomaret basically is a local brand. So they have less restriction in terms of expansions to other cities and regions.
Modern also cited Indonesia's economic slowdown as a reason for its diminishing revenue. The chain closed down 25 underperforming stores in 2016 to cut down operation losses, and Modern closed the remainder of its 7-Eleven stores in 2017. However, a spokesperson from 7-Eleven said, "Indonesia is an important country for us. This is not the end for 7-Eleven's business." The company is hoping to find a new partner to renew its efforts, and it has good reason to believe the right international partner will make all the difference. Take Japan. 7-Eleven entered the country in 1974. It partnered with Japanese chain Ito Yukado, forming York 7 Company to operate its stores. It was so successful that in 2005, it bought out the company. 7 & I Holdings became the global owner of the American chain. Today, there are more than 20,000 7-Elevens in Japan. The U.S. has less than 9,000. So seeking a new international partner may be the key to its success. Indonesian consumers will just have to wait and see.
And you know, that's the tough thing about business. When you need to know your people, your demographic, your customer, right? Like who's going to come and shop in your stores. And based on that, different things work in different areas. And even Starbucks actually failed in, I think, a couple of countries as well. And this was a failure of 7-Eleven not understanding, right? For example, what to cater and what to give the Indonesian shoppers, right? Because the way they had it was they had kind of like a coffee shop so they could come, have coffee, relax. But they didn't have a lot of variety, right? So it was just like a tiny place. Well, what are you going to get there every day, right? And most likely the prices are probably not so inexpensive, so people wouldn't want to buy from there. But I think like their competitors, if they could have big warehouses, lots of items, maybe they have on a coffee shop on a side too, hey, you know, people still come, right? So yeah, that's their failure, and let's see, you know, whether they try it again or they learn their lesson and they move on. So I found this pretty interesting, and I hope you guys did too. So guys, inshallah, tomorrow I've taken some time off and we'll be going to a couple of cities and inshallah we'll bring you guys some cool videos. I got some new gear, so hopefully we can show it to you guys tomorrow and inshallah get some cool shots. So with that said, I hope you guys have yourself a wonderful day. Take care of yourself and your family, inshallah. See you guys in the next video. Take care. Assalamu alaikum.